Hello everybody, this is Dr. Shubhada Khandeparkar. In the last episode, I discussed about the causes of the infertility in an infertile couple. Now today, I'm going to discuss the investigations in the infertile couple. I'll be tackling the female partner today. Now in the female, there is a structure in the brain called hypothalamus. This is a very important structure. It releases certain hormones, which in turn act on another gland in the brain called the pituitary. Now, pituitary is a very important gland which has to function properly in the event the patient should conceive. Now, the pituitary secretes certain hormones, and these are called the FSH, the LH, the thyroid stimulating hormone or the TSH, and also another hormone called the prolactin. FSH is a follicle stimulating hormone and LH is the luteinizing hormone. These both act on the ovary and they stimulate the oocyte or the follicle to mature. The thyroid stimulating hormone acts on the thyroid gland and produces the hormones thyroxine, which also is required for the ovulation. The prolactin or the fourth hormone by the pituitary is also very important. And this also helps the ovulation in the ovaries. So once these hormones are all established in the blood and they are normal, then we go to the next phase, and that is the lower genital region of the female, where we have the ovaries. Now ovaries are an important, extremely important organ in the female genital tract, and they are the main functioning organ which produces the ova or the oocytes, the follicles or the eggs, whatever you can call them in different layman terms. Now we should get a healthy oocyte or a healthy follicle which will rupture and then mature and rupture, and then that in turn meets the sperm and forms the embryo. So to get the good follicle, we have to establish how the ovaries are. How do we function or assess the ovaries? Now the ovaries, the function of the ovaries is assessed mainly one by the ultrasound, and two by another hormone which the ovaries secrete called the anti-Mullerian hormone. Now the anti-Mullerian hormone is a highly sensitive test, I mean the testing or the reporting of the anti-Mullerian hormone should be done in a very standard lab, because it's a very important test and the hormone can be easily wrongly assessed by an ordinary lab. So you have to do it with a very standardized lab. Now once you know the anti-Mullerian hormone is normal, then the other test which we have to do is the ovarian follicle status or the antral follicle count. The anti-Mullerian hormone today tells us how many oocytes, active, good, healthy oocytes this ovary has over a period of time, which we can then decide for the patient that okay, you can wait for some time before you conceive. This tells us the ovarian reserve. Now in this today's modern age, most of the women don't want a child very early in life. They want to settle, even if they are married early, they want to settle, they want to buy a house, they want to plan pregnancy properly, and they always want to, you know, they say that we are not ready for the baby yet immediately, so they have to wait. Maybe they go beyond 30s, 31, 35, 34, whatever. So in that event, we should know, are they having enough ovarian reserve to wait that long? If the anti-Mullerian hormone and the antral follicle count tell us that they don't have enough ovarian reserve, then they should rush. At least they should save or preserve their oocytes, or they should form embryos and preserve their embryos. What is the antral follicle count? Now, antral follicle count is the count which this is the test where we do a transvaginal scan on the second day of menses, and we see in each ovary how many follicles, small follicles or oocytes we can see. We should have at least 3 to 5 good follicles seen, the size of about say 2 to 5 centimeters. So I mean 2 to 5 millimeters, not centimeters, very sorry. So 2 to 5 millimeters. So if we have the size of 2 to 5 millimeters of follicles on either in each ovary, we will say the antral follicle count is good. And that particular cycle, we should get a good follicle coming up in the ovary. Now we can also monitor the follicular status by transvaginal scan during the cycle. till the follicle becomes mature, and that also helps us in the case of an infertile couple to find out the female partner, to find out how the egg is developing, the oocyte is developing, and when it will mature and when it will rupture. So these are the few tests in the infertile female which I have tackled. Now the other tests which are there are on the of the uterus, the tubes and the cervix. Now these three areas I'll tackle in the next episode. Thank you.